Unity supports 2D projects as well as 3D projects. When working on a 2D game or application, workflow can be improved by marking the project as a 2D project in the editor settings, and setting the scene view in the editor mode to 2D mode. When starting a new 2D project, these can be preset in the new project wizard by selecting Setup Defaults for 2D. If a project has been preset as 2D, when the new project opens, it will have its editor settings and scene view configured for a 2D project. This means that the scene view will be in 2D mode, and the default editor mode will be set to 2D. It is important not to confuse the 2D editor mode with the 2D scene view mode. The editor mode describes how the editor will treat the project. The 2D scene view mode simply switches between the 2D and 3D views of the scene. Importantly, these two settings are independent of each other. The scene view mode is indicated in the editor with the 2D mode button in the header bar. With this button, we can toggle the editor between 2D and 3D mode. The editor mode can be changed at any time. To view or change the editor settings, select Edit, Project Settings, Editor. The editor setting that relates to a 2D project is Default Behavior Mode. When Setup Defaults for 2D is selected in the new project wizard, the wizard sets Default Behavior Mode to 2D. When Default Behavior Mode is set to 2D and a new scene is created, the default camera will be set as orthographic, with an orthographic size of 5. When a new image is imported, the default texture importer will be set to the texture type of Sprite rather than texture. For more information on textures, the texture importer and cameras, including the orthographic camera, please see the information linked below. When working on a project, it is important to note that the scene view mode will not affect the game being built in the editor. It is possible to make a 2D game with 2D optimized game objects while the scene view is in 3D mode. It is possible to mix both 2D and 3D elements in the same game. Having the scene view in 2D mode, however, can help improve the workflow of a 2D project and makes working with 2D optimized game objects much easier. When the scene view is in 2D mode, there will be some noticeable changes to the scene view compared to 3D mode. In 2D mode, the scene view is locked in an orthographic, non-perspective view, looking along the Z-axis towards the XY plane. The X-axis is aligned horizontally, and the Y-axis is aligned vertically, with positive values up and to the right and negative values down and to the left. In 2D mode, there is no ability to rotate the scene view camera. So, in 2D mode, the scene gizmo is hidden. To navigate the scene and position game objects in the scene, there are transform tools in the menu bar. These tools are the hand tool, the translate tool, the rotate tool, and the scale tool. In 2D mode, the primary tool will be the translate tool. These tool buttons can be selected by clicking on them or by using a shortcut key. The shortcut keys for these buttons are the Q, W, E, and R keys. An easy way to remember these shortcut keys is that the transform tools are the buttons in the upper left of the editor, and the shortcut keys are the keys in the upper left of the keyboard, and they are in the same order left to right. Q is the shortcut key for the hand tool. W is the shortcut key for the translate tool. E is the shortcut key for the rotate tool. And R is the shortcut key for the scale tool. The hand tool moves the scene view. Click and drag anywhere in the scene to move the view. The hand tool can be modified by using the control keys to zoom the scene view. It's useful to note that the hand tool can be used when any of the other transform tools are active by holding down either the Alt or Option key. The zoom tool can also be used when any of the other transform tools are active by holding down both the control and either the Alt or Option keys. The right mouse button can also be used to activate the hand tool, and the mouse wheel can be used to zoom. The translate, rotate, and scale tools are used to select and position game objects in the scene. With any of the transform tools active, click on a game object to select it. When selected, a gizmo will appear around the game object. Each tool has its own gizmo, and the gizmo will change when the tool is changed. The Translate tool is for moving game objects in the scene. When the scene view mode is set for 2D, the Translate tool can also be used to scale and rotate sprites. If the game object is a sprite and the scene view is in 2D mode, the Translate gizmo is replaced by the Sprite gizmo. The Sprite gizmo adds additional functionality to the Translate tool and improves the 2D workflow. When working with sprites in 2D mode, it is possible to work exclusively with the Translate tool. The Sprite gizmo can be used to position the sprite in the scene by clicking and dragging anywhere within the area of the Sprite gizmo. The Sprite gizmo can also be used to rotate or scale the sprite. To rotate a sprite using the Translate tool, click and drag on a point outside of the Sprite gizmo, near one corner. This point is indicated by the rotate icon appearing on the pointer. To scale a sprite using the Translate tool, click and drag on either the corner or the edge of the Sprite gizmo. This is indicated by the pointer icon changing to a double arrow icon, which will be oriented in the direction the sprite will scale when dragged. By default, the sprite will scale proportionally. To scale the sprite disproportionately, hold the Shift key while dragging on an edge or corner of the Sprite gizmo. When rotating, holding the Shift key will step the rotation in 15-degree increments. The Rotate and Scale tools are used to rotate and scale the selected game object, and their behavior is unchanged in 2D mode. For more information on Transform tools, including the Rotate and Scale tools, please see the information linked below. The order in which sprites are rendered depends upon details controlled by the Sprite Renderer and its sorting layers. For more information on the Sprite Renderer component and sorting layers, please see the information linked below.